One of the common questions that I get a lot from my clients is they want to know if there's anything they need to do to protect their Mac against viruses. And before I give you the one piece of software that I do recommend that you all have, there's one thing I want to clarify just real quick. So anytime you hear me say the words, please go to the description for the link to whatever it may be, I want you to understand that I am saying that for a reason. Because a lot of the malicious software that is out there is accidentally downloaded. People thought they were downloading one thing, it was actually something else. So it's my little way of trying to protect all of you. Just wanted to clarify that. So here's the deal, Macs and viruses, is it possible to get a virus? Technically speaking, yes. Now, I've worked with a couple of thousand people over the course of the last several years, and in my career, I've encountered three. Two of those were in the same week, same virus, same fix, very, very simple. But what is more common on Apple computers is something that's referred to as either Adware or Malware. Basically, it's just a pain in the butt. It doesn't actually cause any harm to your data, but what it can cause is annoying things like pop-ups and websites to redirect. It's basically the crabs of technology, if you will. It's easily treatable, but it's still a pain. The good news is that your digital version of RID, okay guys, we need to work on the metaphors. Is free. So to combat the little buggers of the internet, you're going to need Malwarebytes for Mac. Link in the description of the video. Now, here is how it works. Once you go to that link and click download, that's going to bring that file into, of course, your downloads folder. By the way, the name of the file is MBAM, just so there's no confusion. You're then going to drag that icon from here to there, pretty simple. Now you can find it in your applications folder. And now that you have it, once a month or as needed, if you notice anything weird going on, again, like pop-ups or getting redirected to different websites, just click that application, click scan, let it do its thing. Now, if it does find anything, it's going to trash those files and you're going to need to empty the trash on your computer. Then you're going to reboot. And there's one other thing, if you notice after you reboot that there are still files in your trash, empty it again. There's one more thing, by the way, that I wanna make sure all of you are aware of before we go. So if Malwarebytes should ever find anything and remove it, there is a very, very specific form of adware that will require one additional step on your part, and that is resetting your web browser's homepage and the available search engines. So for directions on how to do that, I will include a list of how to do it for every web browser out there that is available for Mac, at least, in the description of the video. So go there for that information. Thank you, everyone, for watching. If you have not already done so, please hit that little subscribe button. It's a way to easily find out when we come out with new content. And by the way, if you'd like to support what it is that we do here at Tech Talk America, which includes quite a few ways that do not actually cost you money, please visit techtalkamerica.com/support for more information. This is David A. Cox with Tech Talk America. Class dismissed.